cashew. It gives a very close taste to red. Not enough to make it yucky, but I guess some are new vegan, some of you have been vegan for say 3-4 years or longer than that.
For the last 5 years.
Okay, okay, the reason I asked, so how do you feel about like, does dairy put you off, not in terms of knowing what it is, but just the smell or anything when you
the smell, like now even if something has a touch of ghee, I can feel it.
So did you used to like dairy before? Like enjoyed it?
My body actually started reacting to dairy when I started to become vegan. Like I used to get gas.
Okay.
And I still like ghee afterwards, but now I can't.
You can't stand it. Yeah. So that's the thing, right? Because dairy has addictive properties. So even children, not all children like milk. It's very rare that a kid will like milk. Most of the stories you hear is parents forcing the milk down the kids' throat, like to drink the milk, drink it, good for you. So it's a habit that we form. So when you become vegan and you stay vegan for about a year or a little bit more, there's usually a tendency where you feel disgusted when you see milk. Not because of knowing what is in it, but because the smell itself will put you off. It's our natural mechanism. It does, kind of put you off. So. For the newer vegans, do any of you have any of you felt that? But you don't need the milk when you see it.
But the third part is the dairy curd.
Have you tried making peanut curds at home?
I tried, but
no, see, it won't be the exact taste as dairy curds, but did the texture come out well?
Yeah, it's very plain.
Okay.
It won't be any taste.
Okay. So for that, what you do, I understand, because see, your animal milk, in the blood of the animals, there is salt and there is sugar. So that is what is coming into milk, animal milk. So what you do is, next time when you try peanut curd or, at home, add a pinch of salt and a pinch of sugar into the milk and then let it sit. So that will give a little more flavor, one. And secondly, when you curdle regular other milks, animal milk, what happens is, within whatever that half a day, half like overnight it curdles. For peanut milk, you need to leave it for a whole day outside. Then you get the sour taste. It's like drinking milk otherwise, right? It's too plain. So to get the sourness, let it out, stay out for a whole day. Yeah, so if I make it now, tomorrow afternoon is when I put it in the fridge. Monitor it after 6-7 hours, in the morning, just monitor it once in a while, but let it stay out. It stays fine and it becomes sour and it becomes nice. A lot of people have said that about peanut curds. It's just a way of making it and a way of leaving it. You will like it. Definitely. Cashew milk curdles faster, become sour faster, because cashew has a sweetness. Cashew is a sweet nut. So that then all the cultures will eat, enjoy that sweet, and it sours much quicker than... Have you tried cashew milk?
Cashew.
Does it get sour? It gets done well. So you start by putting the nuts and seeds in a dry, completely dry jar, and then you grind it into as fine a powder as possible. That's the first important step. Then you add, so you get it into a powder like this. When it becomes a powder, and then it starts to release the oil and become a little sticky. Its own oil and becomes sticky. So that's the level you get it into. And to that, you add a little water at a time and then blend it till you get a thick cream like this. I don't think you require me to show you the grinding of the cashew and all that, and the powder is enough and this is enough. Now what you do is, now you can make it like this and store it in your fridge if you want, and then add water later, but I usually prefer to make it my whole quantity and then keep it. It depends on how much you've been cooking it. So the amount of water, the ratio, you just base it on by looking at it. That's about it. It's about approximately about a handful of the cashews or a handful of all of them put together, give me about 3-4 liter, minimum 3-4 liter of milk. So little goes a long way. For tea, it's a good idea to make it a little bit watery also, it's fine.
Half teaspoon purpose when you add it.
So start with about 3/4 cup of water for each person. That's enough. If you like sugar in your tea, you can add it while the spices are getting cooked, because then the sugar helps to, it will help to retain the spices more. Somehow it mixes it with each other. And once the tea starts boiling, this is the most important step. You reduce it to, it shouldn't be boiling when you add the milk. It has to be completely simple. You pour in the milk quickly and you stir it. So the milk also, say about, 3/4 cup. This something you would add. So about 3/4 of this, 3/4 of that, about an equal amount. Depends on how thick you made your milk also. And once you add it, now if anyone would like to have a look, you can come. Once you add it, it shouldn't boil a lot. It should be just a light boil, and then you switch it up. Like lightly froth it.